It's been called nature's air conditioning. Faith Salie this morning sweats the details.
We've all felt it. At first comes the trickle, and then comes the flood. It's embarrassed us, even torpedoed a presidential campaign.
Your opponent.
But when was the last time you were grateful for sweat?
Why do you think we are so squeamish when it comes to sweat?
It is utterly out of our control. Think of most other bodily fluids, peeing or
tears.
Tears, right? You can usually hold those back to go to a private place to release them, but sweat, no way. You have zero control.
Sarah Everts is the author of The Joy of Sweat.
Why do humans sweat?
Well, we sweat so that we don't die. Even just a few degrees up is a fever. So we have to keep our body temperature in a very tight window. And sweat is how we do it.
During this summer of record-breaking heat, Everts says no other body function is so essential yet so misunderstood.
What's in our sweat?
Everything. It's not just salt, because we source sweat from blood. Anything that's circulating in your blood comes out in sweat. So our blood is very, very salty. You have lactic acid or vitamins, hormones. It sort of reveals our secrets.
The myth that you can detoxify by sweating it out dates to the ancient Greek doctor Galen, who mistakenly thought that the body excreted superfluous serums as sweat.
Detoxing by sweating is just not a thing. Like, the way our body works is, you know, you filter the bad stuff in your blood out through your kidneys, and that goes out in pee.
Another mechanism to cool the body is sweating.
To understand perspiration, first, you need a little science lesson.
The glands remove water from the blood and then secrete it through the pores onto the surface of the skin.
Those are called eccrine sweat glands, and we have between 2 and 5 million of them all over the body.
How do you measure sweat glands?
Well, I'm going to measure your sweat glands today. We have got our little sweat inducer here.
Andrew Best teaches biology at the Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts.
So this is going to go for 5 minutes, okay. Assuming the batteries don't die.
Okay.
He's been collecting data to study why there's such a variation in sweat gland numbers.
Your sweat glands can double in size, kind of like a muscle. You work out a muscle, it gets bigger, sweat glands do that too, and they can increase how much sweat they make by about 50% as you acclimatize.
Bess says our ability to sweat has played a fundamental role in our becoming human.
I don't think that's widely appreciated, but it's up there with walking on two legs.
While humans have sweat glands all over, most mammals only have them on their paws, hands, or feet.
It's linked with the fight or flight response. Having a little bit of moisture on your fingertips gives you better gripping. This evolved in early mammals tens of millions of years ago to give mammals that ability to have a little extra traction in a moment of panic.
And that ancient response still kicks in today when we find ourselves perspiring when we're nervous. Not only did sweaty hands and feet help us escape our predators, Best says that we have sweat to thank for empowering us as hunters. As sweat glands evolved to spread over increasingly hairless bodies, our meat-eating ancestors could chase down their prey without overheating.
So an animal could outrun us, but we could outsweat it.
Yes, and therefore outrun them over a longer distance.
It's why today we can run marathons. Humans are among the rare mammals who sweat to cool themselves. Other animals use, well, different means.
For example, dogs and many furry animals use their tongue and saliva. They'll lick themselves and evaporate the heat off that way. But as you can imagine, when you have a big bunch of fur, it's not as efficient cooling. Some animals will urinate on themselves, so like seals, for example. Vultures poop on their legs. It's very watery poop. bees vomit on themselves, right? So the next time you're on the subway or a bus and you are grossed out by your fellow humans sweating away, just be glad that, you know, it's just sweat because they could be peeing and vomiting and licking themselves to stay cool.
Everts calls sweating a human superpower because of its astonishing efficiency as a cooling mechanism. So what about it's not the heat, it's the humidity?
Why don't we feel like we're cooling off if we sweat when we're in a humid place?
You know, if you're like in a desert, you often don't even notice that you're sweating. And that's because there's very little water in the air around you. And so that as your sweat is evaporating away, that is being whisked off. When you're in a humid environment, that means effectively that there's like a lot of water molecules in the air. And so if you have like a layer of sweat, it's harder chemically for the evaporation to happen, right? Because there's just so much space for water in the air. It gets harder to cool down when there is a lot of humidity around.
Dry idea.
And as for the saying, never let them see you sweat, you can thank the antiperspirant advertising for that. We buy more than $80 billion worth of antiperspirants every year.
It's okay to be anxious, as long as you don't look anxious.
Dry idea. Never let them see you sweat.
There it is.
Well,
it's done.
Exciting.
I did let them see me sweat, all in the name of science.
Ah, you're dripping a little bit.
I'm dripping.
You're a good sweater.
Thank you.
Yeah.
With about 103 sweat glands per square centimeter, it turns out I have low sweat gland density, according to Best. But my glands did produce a lot of sweat. And Everts reminds me not to feel bad about that.
I kind of think we all need a sweat pep talk. It is this amazing thing that has allowed humans to live anywhere in the world. It also keeps us from dying.
Sweat is a miracle.
It is. I really wish we would all, you know, find a lot less shame and a lot more joy in sweat.